Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. The European Space Agency's Rosetta mission to the comet CG is attracting worldwide attention to comet science. While months remain until the team attempts to land a probe on the comet's surface, astonishing revelations are already confronting scientists on Earth. Like several previously photographed comets, the comet's form and surface bear no resemblance to the dirty snowball envisioned by mainstream astronomers. Mission scientist Holger Sierks says of the comet images, "It was so surprising to see that this is not a smooth, hull-shaped body as we've thought it would be." For decades, mainstream astronomy has described comets as loose aggregates of ices and primordial interstellar dust. However, this expectation has again been falsified by science discovery. According to the Rosetta team, the surface of comet CG features almost no ice, and the temperature is considerably hotter than expected. The comet's water output, which has surprisingly not been expelled from the body's dark side, is also puzzling mission scientists. We asked Wall Thornhill for an overview of the Electric Universe interpretations and predictions for the Rosetta mission.
Science magazine on the 1st of August says, "Europe's Rosetta spacecraft is about to orbit and then land on one of the solar system's most mysterious objects, called 67P Churyumov-Gerasimenko, or 67P for short. About a week ago, the lump of ice and dust tumbled into view as little more than a dot." End of quote. Why is the comet referred to as a lump of ice and dust when overwhelming evidence from earlier comet encounters has not found the expected ice? The Electric Universe has claimed from the beginning that comets are not primordial icy objects, but fragments of planetary bodies ripped from their parent bodies by overwhelming electrical forces. And comet 67P displays an electrically gouged surface. Extraordinary claims like the Electric Universe model of comets doesn't need extraordinary proof. Just the usual scientific proof will do. On the contrary, it seems that long-held consensus stories require extraordinary, in-your-face disproof. But even that seems to fail when it comes to the cherished myth of comet origins and their significance. It is said that comets are the most primitive objects in the solar system. Many scientists think that they have kept a record of the physical and chemical processes that occurred during the early stages of the evolution of our sun and solar system. The ESA website continues, "The abundance of volatile material in comets makes them particularly important and extraordinary objects. This characteristic demonstrates that comets were formed at large distances from the Sun and have been preserved at low temperatures since their formation. Cometary material therefore represents the closest we can get to the conditions that occurred when the Sun and our solar system were born." End of quote. But we know from the Stardust mission that high-temperature minerals are found in a comet's tail. And it's recently been admitted there is no clear boundary between asteroids and comets. But asteroids are supposed to be stony or even metallic, based on meteorite evidence. Yet here the mantra is repeated, and I quote, "Comets have been preserved at low temperatures since their formation," end of quote. It seems that facts have to conform to theory, otherwise the facts are ignored. And that's not science. Another example is the story of the birth of the solar system, repeated endlessly in the media. It has been shown to be rubbish now that we have data on several thousand exoplanetary systems about nearby stars. In Nature of July 3rd, there's a report, "Planets in Chaos," and I quote, "The discovery of thousands of star systems wildly different from our own has demolished ideas about how planets form. Astronomers are searching for a whole new theory," end of quote. Despite this demolition of the story of comets and the birth of the solar system, the Rosetta mission proceeds as if nothing has happened. This should be contrasted with the Electric Universe model, which is based on a much broader range of evidence. Stars are seen to form along vast cosmic lightning bolts in galactic molecular clouds. A lightning filament is the most efficient scavenger of surrounding matter, known to plasma scientists as an electromagnetic pinch effect. The process is remarkably different from the gravitational core accretion model, which has never been shown to work, theoretically. A major difference is that electromagnetic accretion sorts the elements with the heaviest along the filament axis and hydrogen and helium forming an outer atmosphere. Clearly, stars and planets all form together along the axis of the electric current, like beads on a string. As the current subsides, gravity draws nearby objects together, and rather than having a hot core, stars have a cool core. They have no internal thermonuclear fire. Electrical capture forms the weird assortment of exoplanetary systems that we observe. And stars and gas giants may electrically fission to form close-orbiting companions, planets, and moons. So our sun's family is captured. Each planet has its own unique story, which explains why they are all so different. The history of the solar system is punctuated by short episodes of chaos following the capture of a new planet. The Earth's geological record is testament to that. Capture is a messy process involving stupendous electrical exchanges between planetary bodies and their moons as the means of capture and establishing a new stability. In comparison, gravitational theory cannot explain why the solar system is stable, let alone understand how the sun can capture wandering planets. Interplanetary thunderbolts overwhelm gravity and hurl matter from planet surfaces into space to become comets, asteroids, and meteoroids. All surfaces are spark and arc machined in easily identified ways. Comet 67P clearly exhibits the hallmarks of electrical surface erosion. So the electric universe model of comets suggests there are dangers facing the Rosetta mission. One danger comes from underestimating the rockiness of the comet. It is not a primordial conglomerate of ice and dust. It is part of a complex, layered planetary surface that has been roasted black and pitted in a stupendous plasma discharge. So the greatest danger to the Rosetta mission may come from not understanding the electrical nature of comets. Science magazine on the 1st of August says, Rosetta will arrive in time to watch 67P's jets turn on. In the comet's previous orbits, telescopes spotted three active jet areas. Scientists don't understand the precise nature of those jets or how they might be shaping cometary surface features, but they found valuable clues when NASA's Stardust Next mission flew past Temple 1 in 2011. Viewing that comet's active areas from a distance of 181 kilometers, Stardust Next found gas and dust emanating from what appeared to be cliffs surrounding crater-like outgassing scars. End of quote. The electric universe model predicted this manner of erosion on Temple 1. Electrical sculpting of cliff faces is seen in action and mistaken for volcanoes on Jupiter's moon Io. The jets are a form of electrical discharge in a vacuum known as cold cathode jets. The danger for the Rosetta mission is that the discharge may switch from the rocky comet to the angular metallic lander, Philae, which would interfere with its transmission and probably disable its electronics. Given the plight of science today, even such an event is likely to be explained away in terms of the discredited story of comets, rather than tackle the myths at the core of modern science. It happened earlier with my prediction of a flash before impact in the Deep Impact Encounter. The ad hoc official story was for impact with a crust before the phenomenal bright outburst that followed from the depths. But the return mission saw no deep crater. The crater looked like what you might expect upon hitting a rocky planetary surface, not dirty ice or even icy dirt. There is another dangerous misconception that the jets are merely outflowing low-density gases. I quote, on 10th of September, mission managers plan to put Rosetta into a 30-kilometer orbit. At that point, the spacecraft will begin to feel the gentle pressure of the jets on its 64 square meters of solar panels, which will act like giant sails. It's pushing us away all the time, says Matt Taylor, the mission's project scientist. Mission controllers will try to keep the panels pointed edge onto the comet's surface to minimize both dust collection and gas pressure, end of quote. But the jets are electrically charged particles sputtered from the minerals on the comet's surface, which may coat the spacecraft and its solar panels regardless of their orientation. Cathode sputtering is an industrial technique used to evenly coat complex-shaped surfaces, and the electric current carried by those jets could cause arcing on the spacecraft and interference with sensitive instruments. I also expect the electron energies in the jets to exceed the 10 electron volts maximum of the Rosetta Langmuir probe experiment. In any case, electron temperature will be misleading in the comet's electric field because the motion of electrons is non-random. I congratulate the engineers and scientists who have made the Rosetta mission possible. The spacecraft may yet live up to its name, allowing those who understand the electric universe to better decipher the recent history of our electric solar system. Clearly, NASA scientists are not appropriately trained for that interdisciplinary job. They may be making small, incremental concessions for limited electrical activity in space, like electrostatic clumping of matter to form comets, but the science of electric discharges is not taught in any university astrophysics course. Meanwhile, there are electric universe enthusiasts testing electrical scarring in garage experiments, because major breakthroughs often come from inspired outsiders, not from mainstream consensus. History shows that were it not for eminent outsiders, we would still believe the Earth is at the center of the universe. Modern cosmology has yet to free itself of its many myths.
For continuous updates on space news from the electric universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.